Well, good morning, everybody. Firstly, I hope you and your families are keeping safe and healthy in these extremely difficult times. Do take good care of yourselves. Through my journey as an athlete, what kept me going was the happiness I found in the process of training. Many of you may have found what makes you happy, while some of you are still looking for it. Given that, it's a great pleasure to welcome Dr. Rekhi this morning to talk to you all about happiness as the Managing Director of R Systems, a global organization with businesses across the world. He works in a fast-paced environment, which is success-driven, where only excellence is accepted, just like in sport. However, he has spent considerable time finding ways to which we can explore what happiness is and how we can find that happiness within ourselves. This skill is something that is absolutely transferable to our lives as athletes. I'm certain that his experiences and his thoughts would inspire many of you today on your own journeys as well. With that, I have the great pleasure on passing the floor to Dr. Rekhi, and we're really looking forward to this.
Good morning to everybody. As Abhinav said, as Sanjana said, and as all of you know, we are going through challenging times, and some of you may have... Say again? Notes are shown, is it? No, not on my screen. Are you, Sanjana, are you seeing two screens or one screen?
I'm seeing two.
You're seeing two, okay. Then I have to set this right. Which is okay. Are you seeing two or one?
One screen.
One screen. Because if you see two screens, it just complicates everything. So you, all you're seeing is the screen on Secret of Happiness is Acceptance.
That's correct.
Thank you, Sanjana. So we are going through a difficult time, challenging times, and sometimes somebody may say, how can you talk about happiness during this time? Yes, we can try to be happier in difficult times, or we can try to be less unhappier in this time. And the secret that I'm going to talk about is acceptance. Acceptance of the reality that we face. Times are hard, we have to accept it. If we can change certain things, we will change. But if we cannot, then we have to accept. When I was talking to Sanjana earlier on, I asked her, should I give a lecture or should I tell stories? Sanjana said, tell stories. So I'm going to give you stories. Many stories, at least three of them, and let me start with one. There were two monks who were in a foreign country and they got jailed unjust imprisonment, and for no good reasons they were tortured in that jail. They went through a very hard time, and once they were released, after some time of torture and difficult times, they were released. So Monk A was very angry. He said, they unjustifiably tortured us, put us into jail. I will never forget this. I will not ever let this go. Monk B was calm. He said, is there anything we can do about it? No. So if you're going to hold this, and if you're going to be angry, and if you're going to be remembering this every day, then you will live in the same jail for the rest of your life. So what did Monk B do, and what did Monk A do? Monk A was resisting reality. Monk B was accepting reality. Acceptance, when you do, you can move on. You can get calmer. You'll find in your life there are two types of events. One you can control and influence. One you cannot control and influence. What you can control and influence, please do that. certain things you cannot control and influence, and they are not in your favor, and you don't like them, that's unfortunate, but you have to accept them. The secret of happiness practice is acceptance. Acceptance of things when they are not in your favor. Lots of things happen which are not in your favor. There is defeat, there is losses, some relationships break up, some things don't work out, you don't get a promotion. We have to accept. If we fight reality, we'll be unhappy. So why do I call this happiness a practice? Many of you, if not all of you, are athletes. If you practice tennis, you become good at tennis. If you practice badminton, you get good at badminton. If you practice getting angry, you get good at getting angry. If you practice acceptance, you get good at acceptance and happiness. The situation that we've got ourselves in is because at some time we were in denial. Some people said that this is just a flu. It'll pass. It will pass, but it was not as simple as they said it. And then we went about doing our things the way we do it, let down our guards, electioneering and religious bathing, and all of that started. And that is a kind of a resistance or a denial. Why do we do denial? Denial is a way people defend themselves. When certain reality is so hard to accept, we deny it. We resist it. But the problem doesn't go away. And that's how we got into this bigger problem. But now we are probably doing all the things that we need to do, and I'm sure it will be behind us. On a lighter vein, today, being COVID negative is the new positive. So what is acceptance? Acceptance means embracing reality. If it's raining, I want to play cricket, but it starts raining. I can resist it. I can say, I don't like rain. It makes me gloomy. I want it to be sunny. It does not help. Instead, I could say, I'll just play chess or watch TV or catch up on some training and accept reality. So the thing is, if it's raining, let it rain. There is a rainbow behind the rain. So what is happiness? Abhinav talked about a journey. Happiness is a journey. It's not a destination. It is something which we do. Get good feelings, and good feelings in good times as well as in not too good times, hopefully. And then it's moment by moment. It's not a fixed deposit where you can put something in a bank and you keep getting returns of happiness every month, every quarter. It's a moment by moment effort which needs to be made. And lastly, the most important part, when we talk about acceptance, when we are talking about external events which we have to accept, on which we have no choice, there is acceptance of self. We need to accept our own self. Our own self, which sometimes we may believe is not good enough, worthy enough, but we are enough, and acceptance always helps and then helps us to progress better. I want to talk about the mind a little bit before I go into this acceptance and other things. And how negativity helps the mind. Not too good events help the mind. That is because the mind is anti-fragile. What is the meaning of anti-fragile? A glass is fragile. When I put pressure on the glass, it breaks. But when I put pressure on the mind, and athletes will know that, it needs adversity to thrive. It needs defeat, losses, to become better and better. And it's like a rock. The mind is like a rock that becomes a diamond under pressure, under stress, under challenges. And it's like your immune system, which strengthens after exposure to germs. Another thing about the mind is that it works with the law of duality. What is the law of... What is the law of duality? The law of duality says that in life, most things come in twos. They're twos, they're parts of the same thing, but with opposite meanings. And these opposites make experience possible. For instance, suppose you were the only person on earth. There was nobody else. If I asked you, are you tall or short? Would you be able to tell us? No, you need one more person because the brain thinks relatively, not absolutely. It needs a comparison. So hot, cold, short, tall, these are opposites which provide a contrast and make experience possible. To experience A, I have to experience not A. For example, if there was no unhappiness on earth, you will not be able to experience happiness. If I made a video in which you only won, there was no defeat, the victory would be of no meaning. So therefore, negativity, losses, defeats, not too good events help us. They're important part of our lives. Happiness and unhappiness are complementary, like the two wings of an eagle. One cannot exist without the other. You cannot experience happiness if there was no unhappiness. And remember, another thing I will tell you, the mind is such that if you do not have challenges, the mind creates challenges for itself. But then, while if it's an external challenge, the mind is fighting that challenge. But if it's an internal challenge created by the mind fights itself. You are fighting you, which is very hard. So we need to be thankful for both negative events, positive events, happiness, of course, and unhappiness. Coming back to my acceptance topic, which is the secret. Acceptance is not weakness. Acceptance needs a lot of courage when things are not in your favor. It is also not something you agree with. In my story, the monk did not agree with the imprisonment, but it's useless fighting that. I might as well use my energy somewhere else. I shift my focus into something I can influence. And more importantly, I might want you to know that acceptance is not giving up. It is changing your strategy, changing your door that you are now going after. The opposite of acceptance is resistance. When you resist reality, you know what happens? The whole universe you are fighting against. When you accept reality, then the universe works with you. You are in synchrony with the universe. In resistance, what we do when we are resisting and we are not accepting, we are doing shoulding. This should have happened. This should not have happened. That does not help. Then we also end up doing what is mind wandering. Mind wandering, athletes would know, is one reason why we lose. Because we lose focus of the task at hand. Our mind goes to the present or to the future, goes to the past or to the future, and we lose focus. Why is mind wandering a resistance? Because life provides you a moment. That's all you have. Everything else is past, or everything else you don't have, which is future. When you don't accept that moment, mind wanders. Mind wandering does not help in happiness. Then suffering. When you resist reality, you suffer. And that's why they say pain is inevitable. Suffering is optional. We are suffering now with what the situation is today because we could have accepted it and done many things. And last but not least, where self-acceptance is very important. We sometimes resist our own selves, and I've seen people who kind of hate themselves. Lack of self-acceptance is a very strong ingredient for unhappiness. I will now tell you a story. This is a story about a wise Chinese farmer and his horse. Some of you may have heard it, but you're going to hear it again, and we'll take it and learn from it. Once upon a time, there was a wise Chinese farmer. He had a horse. The horse helped him in his farming and taking goods from one place to another on his farm. And he was running a peaceful life with one horse and a small business. One morning, he got up and he found that the horse has run away. He did not have a horse anymore. The neighbors got to know about it. They came to this farmer and said, "This should not have happened. Bad news, Mr. Farmer." The farmer looked up and said, "Who knows what should have happened and what should not have happened? And who knows what is good news and what is bad news?" Few days passed. The farmer now had to toil manually. He didn't have a horse. It was a little hard. Then one day he saw that the old horse was coming back and he was bringing two more horses with him. The farmer now had three horses. His business became better. The neighbors came, said, "Good news, Mr. Farmer." Farmer said, he looked up, said, "Who knows? Good news or not too good news?" Now he had three horses. His business grew. The farmer had a son. The son tried to ride one of the new horses. He fell down and broke his leg. The neighbors came. "Bad news, should not have happened." The farmer said, "Who knows what should happen, what should not happen? Who knows good news or bad news?" A few days passed. The son was lying with a broken leg. The Chinese army came to the village. They took away all the youngsters into the army and enlisted them. The son had a broken leg. They left him. Guess what happened? The neighbors came. Guess what the neighbor said? "Good news, Mr. Farmer." And guess what the farmer said? "Who knows? Good news or bad news?" I want to ask you, if somebody came to the farmer and said, "COVID has come into your village, bad news," what would the farmer say? "Who knows? Good news or bad news?" The moral of the story is, negative events can produce positive results. In my personal life, when I was working in the United States, in a company where it was doing extremely well, I was fired. I was very angry. But I started my own business, and today it's thriving. All negative events probably have something positive underneath them. If you look back in your own life, you will find that what appeared to be negative at one time actually worked out to be positive later on. Life is simple. Everything happens for you, not to you. Meaning, positive things happen for you, even negatives happen for you, not to you. Dalai Lama says, "Sometimes not getting what you want is a wonderful stroke of luck. Getting something you want is good. Sometimes not getting that is also very good." Let me now talk about self-acceptance. Self-acceptance is when I feel I'm not worthy enough. I'm not good enough. And that happens because I compare. I will ask you a question. Is life fair? most probably most people will say life is not fair. But do you expect life to be fair? Most people will say, yes, I expect life to be fair. And do you know why? And that's because we got it from our cousins, the monkeys. It is hardwired into our brain that life must be fair. Everybody must be fair to me. The employer must be fair to me. The coach must be fair to me. Everybody should be fair to me. It's kind of hardwired in. And that we got from monkeys. I will show you a video. There are two monkeys. Monkeys like cucumbers, but they love grapes. So in this video, which is an experiment done, the monkeys, two monkeys are given a task. And for the task, they have a reward. Monkey A is given a cucumber. Monkey B is given a grape. Grape is higher status. Monkey A is fine with cucumber, but once he sees monkey B getting a grape, see what happens. Sanjana, can you hear the video?
Dr. Jake, we can't hear the video, but the video is clear. We can see.
Okay, let me just give me a minute. Mm-hmm. You can't see the sound? Okay. Let's try again. I hope you were able to see this well enough.
We're able to see the video, yes, that's correct.
But you were not able to hear the audio, is it?
Yeah, that's correct.
So were you able to understand what was going on, Rohan?
Yes, so the monkey at the end with the cucumber started rejecting.
Thank you. So the first piece of cucumber was fine. And the second, once she sees the monkey B getting grape, she rejects the cucumber and gets angry. So what is happening here? Is the monkey angry? Monkey A is angry. Monkey A, is he angry at the researcher who's giving the grapes and cucumbers? Is monkey A angry at monkey B? Probably both of them, but truly his anger is at him, her own self. Why is that? She now believes that her self-worth is threatened. The self-worth of monkey B is grapes, which is higher, and self-worth of me is cucumbers, which is lower. So she feels inferior and lower self-worth as compared to monkey B. That is what makes her angry. So this is called some kind of a monkey ego, which we have already, we got hardwired into our brain. We are always comparing. We are always looking at other people, other things. Ego is an identity I create for myself. It's my documentary. It tells me who I am, what I think I am. It's a story I tell myself, this is who I am. And that story is based on the possessions I have, the car I have, the house I have, the medals that I have, the accomplishments that I do. All of that is wonderful, but if it becomes my identity, then what I do is I'm always comparing. Because if one car gives me so much amount of self-worth, two cars will give me more worth. And then if somebody else has a better car, my identity is threatened and I get unhappy. I have no problem with people having a car. I have no problem with people having good houses. But if it becomes an inseparable part of you, an identity, your self-worth, then you have a problem. So in this monkey ego that we have hardwired in our brain, which we are always comparing, what happens is I always come short. I'm not good enough. I'm not thin enough. I'm not beautiful enough. I'm not smart enough. That creates negative emotions of fear, jealousy, envy, shame, and guilt. The other thing happens in ego is I want more and more. Ego is based in lack, in shortage. I'm always trying to fill, add, because I don't feel complete. Then what happens is I believe that if I get something, I'll be happier. So it's future happiness. I always feel insufficient. And the worst thing that happens in ego is that when I'm judging, I'm comparing, I actually start judging and I judge myself. And I land up short and I create an inner critic inside me, which is, I'm not good enough. I'm not worthy enough. I must be perfect. If I make a mistake, I'm bad. Many times, parents and coaches and guides and bullies create an inner critic inside us, which gives us a very hard time. It reduces our confidence level. That's why the biggest obstacle in performance in your life isn't your boss, your job, economy, or even God. It's you not accepting yourself. Once again, I want you to progress. I want you to improve. There are two ways of doing it. One, I'm bad and I need to become good. One, I'm good, I need to become better. I want to accept myself and then progress higher and higher. The other thing that happens is that you lose control. You're not in the driver's seat anymore. You are running around. And you many times feel you're a nail and not the hammer. Things are happening to you and you are a shuttle, not a racket. Things are not in your control. And that makes one very unhappy. How do we get back into control? There is possible. Life will give you adverse events. I have to accept. And then find and do positive action. If you want to conquer the anxiety of life, live in the moment. Mind wandering to past and future does not help. Live in the breath. This is a very important point. We have today realized how important breathing is. We are running around getting oxygen masks. But when we are fine, we never thought about our breath. If you live in the breath, means remain engaged to the breath is always with you. That brings you to the present moment. If on a court, badminton court, tennis court, or whatever sport you're in, your mind will wander off. Get back to your breath. That will bring you back to the moment. That will bring you back to your focus and concentration. Remember, 50% of the time, the mind will wander. That's while some training can be done to help that. But if you are aware that the mind has wandered and you can compassionately bring it back by engaging with the breath and coming into the moment, you'll find you'll do well in life as well as in sports. I'm now coming to the end of my presentation. I'm going to tell you another story. That's the final story. This is about a wise donkey. There was an abandoned well, which had a screen which was very not hard enough. So this donkey walked over that screen and he fell down far below into the well. Misfortune struck him. Adversity struck him. He cried, prayed. Also did the same thing we all would do. What a fool I am. I should not have walked on that screen on top of the abandoned well. Then after some time, he saw the owner looking down. So the donkey was happy. The owner is going to pull me out. Some time passed. Rocks, gravel, sand was falling on the donkey. What happened? Then the owner went to the neighbors and the neighbors said, this is an abandoned well. Our kids will fall into it. Let's just cover it up. So donkey realized they're going to bury me alive. Wow. Of course, the donkey was very scared. He thought of a plan. He came to the present moment. No past, what has happened, has happened. No future, where I will reach, no. The present moment. Shake it off, step up. That was his plan. Rocks and gravel were falling on him. Shake it off, step up. He started rising. His thoughts would go, oh, will I ever be able to reach there, the top? He said, shake it off. Shake it off meaning, shake off the negative thoughts too. Step up. And this became a kind of a game for him. He forgot the goal. He started enjoying the journey. The journey was good enough. Shake it off. Shake off the negative thoughts. Shake off the gravel, rock falling on me. Step up. Pound your feet. Step up. And a lot of time passed. He came closer to his goal of stepping out. He was still inside. And then the neighbors who were actually wanting to bury him alive started cheering him. But this donkey was smart. He just stuck to the present moment. He did not get distracted. A game is not won till it is won. A game is not lost till it's lost. And then he walked out of the abandoned well. The trophy was waiting for him. He did not want the trophy. He just wanted to play the game. The trophies came to him. He didn't go to the trophy. That's what athletes must do. Stay in the moment. Stay engaged. Stay focused. Connect to your breath. And don't worry about the goal. You'll be surprised. The trophy will knock on your shoulders and say, this is for you. Stay in the present moment. Focus on action steps. We have already said some things are not in your control. Accept them. Take the tiniest of the tiny steps. If a relationship is not working out, take a tiny step. If some things are not working out, instead of ruminating and brooding about it, take a tiny positive step. Just like my donkey, taking that small step. That's all what we need to do. Don't go for the trophy. Let the trophy come to you. And if this you remember, Life is very simple. Everything happens for you, not to you. When rocks are falling down, that's also happening for you, not to you. We already said negative events make our anti-fragile mind better and better. We'll come out much better out of this COVID situation. I sympathize. We have lost our friends. Our friends are suffering. But let's do all the small things that we can do, whether it's masking ourselves, whether it's providing food to another family, take positive steps. Small, tiny steps is all that one can do, and that's what I want you to. That brings me to the end of my presentation. I summarize, acceptance is the secret to happiness. Many things will happen which are not in your favor, but they're good for you. Things you cannot change, cannot influence, accept them. Happy people accept negative events better. Happy athletes accept defeat better, meaning they learn from the defeat. They do not ruminate on the defeat. Successful athletes have lost better. Stay in the moment. Take tiny action steps. Anxiety is in the future. Regret is in the past. All you have is that moment. The mind will go to the past and to the future. Your brain, which is hardwired, stays in the present. But what happens is, when mind goes to the future, it brings the future worry into the brain, and the brain thinks it is today's worry. It is tomorrow's worry, but the brain doesn't understand that. So you start worrying today about something which may or may not happen tomorrow. Sometimes not getting what you want is a stroke of luck. Remember, we are always comparing. We are an ego. We have to get outside our identity, because we will fall short. We are complete ourselves. We have to accept ourselves. And lastly, but not least, if you remember this, my presentation at the birthday, everything happens for you, not to you. The universe is out to help you, not to attack you. Thank you very much. That brings me to the end of my presentation. And I appreciate you joining this presentation. I know all of us are going through difficult times, and I am very grateful that you were able to join it.
While we wait for others to maybe put in a few more questions, I just like to take this opportunity again, Dr. Reiki, to thank you wholeheartedly for this really wonderful, enlightening, and riveting presentation today. I think all our athletes, I'm sure, gained a lot from it, not just for performance in sport, but also for becoming champions in life. And I think that is equally important than just for how they perform on the field of play. I think it also reminds them that not to believe in the equation that a gold medal equals happiness, but rather reverse the equation and live a life where happiness equals a gold medal. And secondly, I think the point that you made on self-worth was something so important. I think the self-worth of all our athletes must not be determined on where their name is on the ranking list. They're human beings, and there's so much more to them, so many different sides to them as human beings than just what their athletic prowess is. While they all, of course, live the dream of becoming the best that they can, I think it is so very important for all of them to realize that they also have to develop as holistic human beings, and that happiness is at the core of everything in life. So again, thank you so very, very much for giving this insight, which I'm sure is born out of several experiences of your life. And thank you so much for sharing it with all the athletes. And again, my gratitude and thanks today for your time. And as well for all your support that you've extended to the foundation. And I really hope that we can do this again at some point of time, and again, connect back with you and have more engagements with you for all our athletes. Thank you again.
Okay, Rohan. Okay, Abhinav, thank you very much. And it was wonderful talking to all of you, and stay safe and be well.
Thank you.